I planned to make this podcast for more than a year, and finally here it is. Firstly, I'd like to warn that I will not focus too much on all of those myths about Nattramn, because there are already lots of the reviews where people discuss them. Here I'd like to talk more about Nattramn's music and his artistic skills. I remember that time when I learned about Nattramn. I've heard some of his music and have seen some reviews about him. I thought it was creepy but very interesting. Later, I started learning more information about him and stopped perceiving Nattramn as some kind of crazy demonic figure. I think he is an outstanding artist with his own unique point of view on art and the world in general. I really don't take any of those rumors about him seriously anymore. I stopped completely after visiting his both websites. They were interesting to look at, but most of the information there was, "Ooh, we're evil. I am evil. Our ideology is to spread sadness around the world. Buy all our merch." What only confirmed that all of those spooky rumors are nothing but a promo. And it's okay, I personally don't have anything against it when an artist is promoting his music in such a creative and unusual way. It's pretty entertaining. If more bands and artists had the same approach, the music scene would be more exciting. I would also say Nattramn is a genius artist who deserves attention even from those people who are not into the genres he works in. Well, of course, I need to tell first about who is Nattramn. There's very little information about him. Again, most of it is just rumors and unconfirmed information that might be true. But well, there is still something that is known about him. His real name is Mikael Nilsson. He was born in the Swedish town Markaryd. He was born in September 7th, 1975. He is 45 years old. He started making music in 1994. His first project that he started in 1994 was called Sinus Cross, that after 1995 was renamed as Trencadis. The only thing that was made under this project was 21-minute ambient song Odelagt. It was released in 1996, and I honestly wouldn't say anything very special about it. I don't mean it's not worth listening, it's a pretty decent and well-composed ambient song. I think it belongs to the dungeon synth subgenre. If you're looking for a very atmospheric ambient music, this one can be good for you. Well, now let's pass to his second and the most infamous project, Silencer. It's the DSBM band that was started in 1998 by Nattramn and his friend Lear. Nattramn was the vocalist, Lear was the guitarist, also there were Steve Woltz as the drummer and Jonas Mattsson as the session drummer. Because the band has never performed live and never gave any interviews, there is very little known about them. They released just one demo in 1998 that is called Death Pierce Me, and a full-length album with the same title in 2001. Like the vast majority of people who know about Nattramn's music, Silencer was the first project that I've learned about. The first time I've heard about Nattramn was in 2017, when I only started listening to metal music. At that period, I already knew about the DSBM genre, and Silencer was one of the first bands that made me like it. In comparison with many other metal bands, Silencer still sounds original. Especially I like their approach to the non-metal patterns like finger styles on the guitar and the synths. They create a truly awesome contrast to the extreme metal parts. I think Steve Woltz and Jonas Madsen did a really great job about the drums. They sound very interesting. Many people find Nattramn's vocals silly and ridiculous and think that Silencer would be better without them. I'm absolutely disagree with it. Firstly, without Nattramn, Silencer wouldn't be Silencer. Secondly, his high-pitched hysterical screams are the main reason why the band became so unique and memorable. In my opinion, Death Pierce Me is one of the greatest metal albums. There never was anything like that before, and there never will be anything like that after. I remember in that period when I checked it out, I listened to it with a joy, but at the same time without a surprise. It's just one of those cases when I listen to most of the songs so often, separately, that there wasn't much excitement already when I've heard them on the album. While listening to the album, I just heard those songs in a specific order, with just some new songs that I haven't heard before. I'm not saying it's ruined my perception of the album is great, I just knew most of the songs already while listening to the album, but it's fine. I'm also glad that they decided to record the album in the professional studio and prove that an artist doesn't have to be lo-fi to sound atmospheric, convincing and just creepy. The album's got a decent quality of the sound and those engineers who mixed it did an awesome job. Besides the music itself, of course, I need to mention all of the myths that are still surrounding the band. What can I say about it? I don't believe it. I think someone needs to be very silly and naive to believe it. The first myth is that Nattramn actually never existed and he was nothing but a myth himself. I think there is already enough information available to be sure it's not true. The second myth about Nattramn cutting himself while recording the vocals to make them sound more extreme. Maybe he did some kind of self-harm like many other DSBM artists, but nothing more. Those who worked with him on the album don't remember such things, and I honestly doubt they would let him cut himself right in the studio. And obviously Nattramn didn't cut off his hands and didn't put pig's legs instead. I'm not even sure if I need to say why it's nonsense. He just would die from losing too much blood or he would die from infection. So no, he did not cut off his hands. And no, he didn't record his vocals while laying inside a coffin. Even he confirmed it himself by telling he is claustrophobic. The third myth is that everyone who worked with Silencer on the album are either dead or got vanished. No, there are still people who are working in the studio where Silencer recorded, and the people who worked, who helped them, they're fine, they're alright. So, okay, so the band Silencer broke up in 2001 for unknown reasons. The guitarist Lear was playing in Shining between 2005 and 2006 after Silencer's breakup. As I know, recently he still makes music, but already more for himself. The drummer Steve Woltz is playing in the bands Bethlehem since 2000 and Imperia since 2004. What about Nattramn? By the unconfirmed information, he ended up in the psychiatric clinic. Some people claim that it could be the reason why Silencer disbanded. I just would like to mention briefly and never talk about it again about one thing, that there was a case that in the May of 2001, Nattramn escaped from the clinic, left a note that he is going to kill some little girls and get famous by the name The Quick Thomas. So when he escaped, he attacked a girl with an axe. The girl was injured but safe, and the quick Thomas was captured by the police later when he tried to hide, and also when he tried to commit suicide by chopping himself with an axe. And but he was captured by the police and sent to the psychiatric clinic for 5 more years. There are rumors that it could be Nattramn's brother. Anyway, true or not, but it sure sounds like some kind of mumbo jumbo, so let's move on. According to the available information, after the suicide attempt, Nattramn was put in the Sankt Siegfried's Hukus, a psychiatric hospital located in Växjö. It is unknown if he went there voluntarily or was forced to stay there. But while being there, he decided to continue living in Växjö even after he was released from the hospital. After some time in the psychiatric clinic, it was allowed for him to make music as the therapy, and this is how his third project was started. In 2004, he started his new project, Diagnose, Lebensgefahr. In 2007, the only album by the project was released. It's called Transformalin. It contained a mixture of different genres such as industrial, noise, drone and ambient. Nattramn used there the sounds of different fragments of the telephone conversations, some medical tools, also the hospital staff was helping Nattramn with the album. You can also hear his vocals there, but they were completely different from what he did on the Silencers album. On the Transformalin, they were much lower and harsher. On the first issue, every copy of the album's booklet had a drop of blood on it. Also, different issues of the album have different versions of the album covers. Well, it is a very unique album, and I don't even know how to describe it, it's just weird. If you would like to know how it sounds, you just need to listen to it. In my opinion, it is the best work by Nattramn. Firstly, because it's his solo work, where he fully was responsible for it. And I think it is his most sincere and personal work. I know many people could disagree by saying Death Pierce Me is his best work, but in my opinion, Transformalin is. Because Death Pierce Me is a unique album in metal, but Transformalin is unique in all music. Again, you'll never find anything like that. There never been anything like that before, and there never will be anything like that after. Transformalin is one of my favorite industrial music albums, and listening to it was one of the most interesting experiences for me in music. I remember when I decided to check it out, I was sitting in the bus, I was completely exhausted and stressed out. I took my phone where I downloaded the album and turned it on. I was listening to it in headphones and tried to make it a little louder to don't hear the sounds of the bus. It felt as if I was a heroin addict for a moment, and the music was injected right into my ears. I felt relaxed because it was like a meditation. Yes, the music there is harsh and the lyrics are scary as well, but my mood at that moment absolutely approved such kind of atmosphere and sound. The album ended right when I needed to go out of the bus. As I went out and the album ended, I felt a pretty strange sort of relief, and then I realized that the album is a masterpiece. Besides music, I definitely need to mention the book that Nattramn released in 2011 that is called Gris Hjärta, what translates in English as Pig's Heart. The book contained Nattramn's new photos, poetry and drawings. It was issued in Swedish and English languages. I wanted to read it, but unfortunately I couldn't find an English version anywhere. I tried to download it as well, but the version that I could find was absolutely unreadable. What is Nattramn doing recently? Well, it is clear that he doesn't like publicity, so it's unknown what he is doing now. There were rumors in the last few years that he is going to return to the extreme metal with a new band, but he didn't release anything yet. There is also a photo of unmasked Nattramn appeared on the internet. Whether it's a real photo of Nattramn or not is unknown. The websites about Nattramn, Diagnose, Lebensgefahr, and his own label Humani Animali Liberati are still available, and you can even order his merch and support him. It's unknown if he'll release anything else in the future, but Nattramn is an absolute genius, and his art is definitely worth checking at least once.